There are two ways to herd sheep. There's a right way, and there's a wrong way. The right way to herd sheep is to watch them, to take care of them. In Navajo, we say, in English, taking care of things is called responsibility. Responsibility is good. Taking care of things is good. This is the right way. But there is also a wrong way to herd sheep. This would be bad any place. No one likes a person who does not take care of things. Here is a telephone. Listen. When your telephone rings, you have a responsibility. You should take care of it. Like herding sheep, there is a right way and a wrong way. Let's see how a sleepy sheep herder might answer the telephone.
Hello.
Is Joe Yazzie there?
No.
Would you see if you could find him?
He's not here.
Would you please give him a message? Tell him his social security card has arrived and to come over and get it as soon as he can.
Someone called for you.
Who?
Don't know.
What do you want?
Don't know.
No one likes a person who does not take care of things. This boy was not responsible. He did not take care of the telephone call. Let's learn the right way to answer the telephone. When a phone rings, answer it quickly. If you are working, stop and answer the phone as soon as you can. Always answer by giving the location of the phone and your name. If you are working in someone's home, you would answer the phone like this.
Anderson's residence, Mary Yazzie speaking.
If you are working in an office, you could answer the phone like this.
Boys Advisor's Office, Lieutenant Jenny speaking.
If you are in a dormitory, you would answer the phone like this.
Boys Dormitory, Building 21, second floor, Billy Begay speaking.
This is Mr. Harris, the boys' advisor. I want to speak to Joe Yazzie.
Just a moment, please.
Joe?
Yeah?
Mr. Harris wants to talk to you on telephone.
Thanks. I'll be right there.
Everyone likes a person who is responsible. Everyone likes a person who takes care of telephone calls. Did you notice? Billy Begay is good on the phone. Let's watch him take another call for Joe Yazzie.
Would you call him to the phone, please?
I'll see if he's here.
Where's Joe?
I'm not sure. I think he went over to the canteen.
Thanks.
He is not here, Mr. Harris. We're not sure. He may have gone to the canteen.
All right. Would you please give him this message?
Just a moment, Mr. Harris. I better write it down.
All right. I'll wait.
Billy writes down who the call is for. He also writes down the name and number of the person who called.
And what is your telephone number, Mr. Harris?
315.
With the call finished, Billy has written everything down. The note is delivered to the attendant. If he is out, slip the message under the door. When Billy sees Joe later, he tells him about the message.
I took a message for you on the telephone, Joe.
Who was it?
Mr. Harris. I wrote it all down and gave the note to the attendant.
Thanks. I'll see about that right away.
You're welcome.
Mary Yazzie is just as good as Billy Begay. Let's see how she handled a call for Mrs. Anderson.
Anderson's residence. Mary Yazzie speaking.
Is Mrs. Anderson home?
No, she isn't. She's gone shopping and would be back around 4 o'clock. Could I take a message?
Yes. Will you please tell her that Mrs. Jones called and I would like to have her call me when she returns?
Would you wait a moment while I write that down?
I'll be glad to wait.
For Mrs. Anderson, your name, Mrs. Jones, and you wanted to call you at 1726. Thank you, Mrs. Jones.
Is everything all right, Mary?
Yes, Mrs. Anderson. I have a telephone message here that I wrote down for you.
Oh, thank you. I'm certainly glad you wrote it down.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll call her right away.
Answering the telephone is easy if you remember 3 rules. First, answer the phone as soon as it rings. Second, always give the location of the phone and your name.
Boys dormitory, building 21, second floor, Billy Begay speaking.
Third, write the message down and deliver it. When you answer the telephone, be responsible. Take care of the call.